One of the things that's most unusual about you is that you went from the boot room to the boardroom. Bring us to that point when you put a consortium together in 06 to buy Sunderland. And the first thing, of course, you did was you sacked the manager.
Yeah, the manager was having a rough time. It was a good decision. One win out of five games, get him out. And also Roy Keane was available. Big decision from the chairman, but it was himself he was sacking, so that was OK. I think Franny Lee influenced me. Probably you'd remember him,
yes.
Ivan. He was a famous Man City footballer, played with England, left the world of football, went to horse racing, amongst other business interests, and came back as chairman of Man City. And I was there at that time. And I don't know whether that rubbed off on me, but the future held the same thing for me. And when I went up to Sunderland, look, a bad start, but things went well. And in the finish, Howard Wilkinson came and moved me on very quickly. And I wanted to see the chairman before I left to explain how I thought he was getting it wrong. It was the wrong appointment. He wouldn't see me. So I sent a message to him to say, well, you never know, one day I'll come back. And his vice chairman said, oh, we'd love to have you as a manager. And I did actually say to John Fickling, his name was, I'll be back to run the club properly. Now, that was real ballsy. At that time, I was outraged because, I thought I was going to be around coaching and be manager of the club, but Howard Wilkinson came in and got rid of me almost instantly. So I think that's where I come from. 3 years later, having not really found my way outside of the game, thankfully, I had some really good friends over here, people who were doing well in business. And when I came up with the idea, they were good enough to back me. They were called the Drummondville Consortium, but really they were guys who I'd socialised with or went golfing with. But generally just good friends, people like Sean Mulryan, Charlie Chalk, Louis Fitzgerald. One or two others came along, Jack Tierney, who you'll know, Nace. They were good. Pat Byrne, a man from Athlone, a great guy. And Patsy Byrne, sadly no longer with us, Patsy, from Kerry, from Douai County, Kerry. He was the life and soul of it. He was in London.
And now, why Sunderland? Of all the clubs you play for, what is it about Sunderland that you fell in love with? These lads aren't all Sunderland fans, sure they're not? They're back in they're not back in Sunderland.
Yeah, I couldn't afford Arsenal or Man City. At the time, I was part of a Sunderland journey that got rudely interrupted by a swift axing of Peter Reid after a poor start one season. And the team that had kind of built itself up under Peter was getting old and it hadn't been replenished. And I always felt, you know, in the couple of years after I left that, you know, Mick was dealt a really poor hand. He wasn't given much money to spend. That's Mick McCarthy who got the job after Howard Wilkinson. And it was a tough station for two or three years. And I knew it could be better because I knew it could be tapped into far more, the great love of the club that the people have and how important it was to the people of Sunderland. So we laugh and joke sometimes and say football is a religion. But those of you who might have seen the Sunderland Till I Die documentaries on Netflix, you will know that Sunderland football, it just means everything. All right. Up there. So I knew something to get there.